Just want to ask you about using MTB gene expert from the ileal biopsy to detect tuberculosis.
Oh, gene expert. Yes, yes. In fact, we were sending this very oftenly, but I have not found anybody. If anybody in the audience is having a good experience, can highlight on this. Because in my experience, it is not of much
use. I sent around 20 of my patients. None of them came back as positive.
I think your voice is not clear, actually. Either you are very close.
In my patients, you know, because when I was in working in UK, I wasn't bothered about sending this routinely. But here, as you rightly mentioned, I want to rule out tuberculosis before I start them on an immunosuppressive regimen. So I do, when I suspect tuberculosis, when there is no, it's not very clear, I was sending routinely ileal biopsy sample for MTB gene expert. Probably 20 of them I would have sent so far, but none of them came back as positive.
Yeah. But so I think same is experience with me.
Yeah.
If anybody who is having good experience on gene expert, you know, as a diagnostic tool, I think can come up and tell us.
Yeah. This gene expert, actually, I had discussed with Dr. Soumya Swaminathan regarding gene expert. She said tissue from colon is not very good. It's not very sensitive. They get the best with probably bowel and sputum. That is the highest yield. But we are continuing to use it because somewhere we can get. But smear, I think still sending AFB for smear and culture should not be thing.
Usually my policy is to take AFB staining, culture, and gene expert. All three combined, actually.
Yeah, surely.
Take it in NS samples.
Hello. Question is for Dr. Malathi. So I know your topic was top-down versus step-up. But in Europe and now in USA, nutritional therapy for Crohn's disease is getting more and more popular. How do you see that in your approach to these patients? Where do you place that? Thank you.
Yeah. So this is different. Nutritional therapy itself, that is exclusive enteral nutrition. I think even the guidelines for management of Crohn's, the ECO guidelines, they take it as you can start when the child can tolerate oral feeds. That means it will be only a mild to moderate Crohn's disease. It is not going to be a severe Crohn's. You can try elemental nutrition, but we know the problems. Compliance is not there, cost. But at least try for 2 weeks because you're not going to use immunosuppressants. I think we do have a chart for that. And then we go in for steroids if they don't respond or they don't are not compliant. Because it's very difficult for ask a child who's 6 years, 7 years to be on exclusive enteral nutrition for 8 weeks without taking anything. It's difficult. And that is our problem. But we should try that because we can avoid immunosuppressive. But for a severe disease where you are thinking of top down, I think enteral nutrition or nutrition should just be a supplement because, you know, you need nutrition. If you don't give a proper nutrition, the child is not going to respond. I think that would be a good thing.
Yeah, I agree with her because the literature shows that the exclusive enteral nutrition is as equal to steroid without side effects. So it should be at that level, first level. When it comes to more than that, then I think the algorithm of immunosuppressants and biologic would come.
Dr. Yacha.
Very good information. A lot of information has emanated from Dr. Thapa and all the speakers here. Regarding this, what you said about the tuberculosis diagnosis, I think imaging is one very good modality, CT scan or MR. When you see the necrotic lymph nodes, it is almost, in a way, tuberculosis versus stones. There's a good distinction between the two. Secondly, regarding this, what you said about the gene expert, it is useful, as you rightly said, for diagnosis purposes, initial, no good, no good. But for MDR, XTA, when you are extended tuberculosis resistance, it's a good modality to find out are you actually dealing with those patients. It's not uncommon. Now we are having a rise of MDR tuberculosis in our, at least at our center. We already described some of the cases in the literature how the MDR is there. Secondly, regarding this, Dr. Malathi has shown the last slide, which is very beautiful. That is the message, actually, that for Crohn's disease is a treatment, high risk has to be identified and given the top-down therapy, and the rest of them we can still toil with the step-up therapy, because the cost factor is there. I would like to know from you, ADA versus infliximab, what would you prefer? You said they are equal. So in current era, what would you prefer?
Now in the current era, we've always found, actually I think the others in India also find, the younger the child, somehow less than 6 years, when they already have difficult problems in managing, infliximab seems to be working better for them, though it is not child friendly. So switching them from infliximab to ADA, I think, is not a thing. But when the child is older than 6 years, they behave more like the classical CD of the adults. Their adalimumab seems to work as the drug. You don't have to start infliximab, then go to ADA. It is child-friendly, and they are able to take it with their pediatricians itself. And seems to be the induction of remission is more or less the same. The studies have clearly shown that induction of remission for that group older than 6 years. Less than 6 years, still people and others, and I have my own thing, I always find infliximab, though I feel, why should I give infliximab for this child when adalimumab is working? But it didn't work. And then I had to go back to infliximab, actually burnt my fingers. But infliximab is working. So somehow infliximab studies, also a large studies have shown only infliximab is working. Adalimumab, they are not doing too much of trials for less than six. So I think their behavior pattern is different. So I would also recommend when you all start, especially for the early onset VIBD and the very onset, to start infliximab and try. If we fail, then maybe by that time, if vedolizumab comes, we may have a better drug. Integrin, I think we just have to go to another molecule rather than trying, I don't know whether you will also agree, Nikhil. Same thing, TNF-alpha itself, we need not modulate. We can go to the next step.
I think whatever Malati has said, I agree with her, because infliximab still remains a very good drug as a biological. We had to, you know, we had given adalimumab to two patients, you know, exchange of this because of subcutaneous route and so on and so forth, but this didn't do well. We had to revert back to infliximab. So I think infliximab still remains a very good drug for as a biological treatment. Yes.
Just one comment on Dr. Yacha's second question. We actually positively use AAB culture for the diagnosis of tuberculosis over Crohn's disease. It's one of the very important, and we need adequate number of biopsies to get positive AAB culture.
Kunal, sorry, just sharing experience and a comment, because from where I work, we use exclusive enteral nutrition as a standard induction, as well as bridge to surgery. So say if the medical therapies fail, rather than putting on steroid before a surgery, we'll use the exclusive enteral nutrition. Other thing about anti-TNFs, I think therapeutic drug monitoring has taken over a lot, and when we are saying not responding to infliximab, we are using more and more, so even 10 milligram per kilo 4 weekly if required be, as well as to think about as anti-TNF placement, 60% to 70% of whether high risk or non-high risk at presentation will turn into anti-TNF soon, like within 1 year of diagnosis. So placing them, where I work, we are limited by resources in basically in getting the medication versus here. I know the cost is a problem, but whoever can afford can go on to it earlier. That's what I feel.
Okay. Because of the paucity of the time, the last question. Yeah.
Dr. Malati, this is regarding use of biologics in younger population. The biologic, they don't work that well in the younger age group. So would you recommend top-up therapy rather than step down in this age group?
Yeah, see, the problem with this younger doctor is not because the rest, their phenotype itself may be different. Exactly. They may be monogenic IBD. I think you have to work them up in a very different way. And younger they are, the more younger, less than 2 years, you are going to have problems. So it's just not a Crohn's. It may be Crohn's-like, it may be IBD-like, there may be immune globulin deficiencies. So working up is different, but what is available now is only infliximab if you feel it is Crohn's disease and supportive treatment.
Right. Just a small comment. I was just talking to Dr. Mittal. For enteral nutrition, what we are advocating as a first-line treatment, that is for the small bowel Crohn's disease. But whenever we are having a patient who has got colonic involvement in isolation or in combination with small bowel, enteral nutrition seems to be working less. Am I right, sir? So therefore, isolate a small bowel, it may be worth a trial. That's it.
Dr. Yacha has always the last word. Let us break this session. Thank you.
Yeah, I think one thing before we end actually. As far as the biopsies are concerned, you know, these are famous things. You know, in tuberculosis, you have a lot of nodularity. You know, they say dig well biopsies. If you have to take multiple biopsies from the base of the, you know, so-called that nodule, multiple biopsies, take for smear, and also for, I mean, AFB staining, cytology, and also histopathology and gene expert. These are the things which can be sent to, you know, increase the efficacy of picking of tuberculosis, I think, which is well described from PGI itself, actually. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you.